President Biden signed even more executive orders today. For those keeping track at home, keeping score at home, we're up to a whopping 43. This latest round focuses on immigration and dismantles many of President Trump's signature policies. Here's what President Biden said earlier today.
I'm not making new law. I'm eliminating bad policy. The last president of the United States issued executive orders I thought were very counterproductive to our security, counterproductive to who we are as a country.
We understand why people want to come to this country, to escape persecution, to taste freedom and liberty, to know hard work and education and a level playing field can combine forces to transform lives. Escaping a country rife with conflict is one thing. Picking a new home is another. And America is picked more than all other countries combined because we are a country that embraces justice, we reward fairness, and we're a nation of laws. In fact, if you look at the oath new citizens take, the law is mentioned six different times. Six times in one paragraph. Six times these new citizens swear allegiance to this thing we call the law. So it is bitterly ironic that you could break this thing we call the law and then claim allegiance to this thing we call the law. It is ironic, to say the least, that you would reward people who do not follow the law by administering an oath requiring them to follow the law. You know, President Obama used to say from time to time that he wanted a country where everyone plays by the same rules. With respect, President Obama, they aren't called rules in this country. They're called laws. Presidents take an oath to enforce those laws, even the ones you don't agree with. And with respect to immigration, history is whispering we have traveled this road before. In 1986, we were told immigration was settled. We were told that in exchange for secure borders and employment verification, those who entered the country illegally would not suffer the full panoply of legal consequences. In the minds of many, the country got the amnesty, but is still waiting 35 years later for the border security and the employment security. But the greatest consequence that comes when government does not keep its word is a government no one trusts anymore. Presidents should not issue executive orders to supplant Congress, regardless of political party. Presidents should not change the law. They should change the law the right way, the only way, the constitutional way, regardless of party. Presidents, most of all, should represent the interest of the American citizens, regardless of party. Americans have been through one of the toughest years in our history. They're suffering. They are hurting. There is economic uncertainty. Jobs have been lost. Hours have been cut. Families are in dire need. If you are wondering what your government response to this economic catastrophe has been, I want you to just listen to some of their advice. The Secretary of Transportation said you should focus on finding a new job, a better job. John Kerry suggested making solar panels. Vice President Kamala Harris said it's time to get out of the coal mines and start clearing landmines. The people who are telling you this are already rich. They already have jobs. In fact, they have government jobs. And to get some of those government jobs, you have to take an oath to protect and defend the United States. Maybe they could start by protecting and defending your job and your right to provide for your family.